understanding why some macadamia farms are able to achieve high yield and quality results year after year is important for improving overall industry productivity. Industry benchmarking has revealed high variability in productivity between farms and also between seasons for individual farms. Benchmarking allows us to take a closer look at the top performing farms to try and work out what they have in common that makes them so successful. Now in its 11th year, the Benchmark Project has tracked individual farm performance over many seasons to identify consistent high performers. Top performing farms are those whose average long-term productivity, measured as salable kernel per bearing hectare, falls within the top 25% of the benchmark sample. Because we are looking at the long-term average, farms need to have submitted data for a minimum of 4 seasons, including the current year. A total of 48 top-performing farms were identified for the 2018 season. When we compare the difference in average yield between the top-performing farms and all other mature farms in the benchmark sample, we can see the productivity gap between the two groups. Over the last 10 years, the difference in yield between the two groups was more than half a tonne of salable kernel per hectare, with top-performing farms achieving 1.32 tonnes, compared with an average of 0.77 tonnes for all other mature farms. If we take the current average nut and shell price of $5.80 per kilogram, this is a difference of over $8,000 per hectare. If we were to look at the 5 highest producing farms in the benchmark sample, which average nearly 5 tonnes of nut and shell per bearing hectare, this equates to approximately twice the revenue per hectare of other mature farms. Like the broader benchmark sample, top performing farms also experience seasonal yield fluctuations. There are also some interesting insights when looking at expenditure trends of top performing farms. When looking at total costs per hectare, top performing farms spent 24% more than all other farms that supplied cost of production data. When breaking those costs down further still, top performing farms spent 30% more on both crop nutrition and crop protection. Even though costs per bearing hectare were higher, their high productivity meant that their costs per tonne of salable kernel were actually 30% lower than other farms in the sample. This supports previous case studies, which found that some farms with higher expenditure achieved higher productivity. Benchmarking also shows that top performing farms consistently achieve a higher average salable kernel recovery, approximately 2.5% higher. This means that these farms generally achieve higher nut and shell prices each year through quality bonuses. A similar pattern was evident for reject kernel recovery results. Contributing to this were lower levels of insect damage, mold, discoloration, and immaturity. So what are the key things that contribute to sustained high productivity of top performing farms? A recent survey has provided some useful insights. Number one was attention to detail, ensuring timeliness and forward planning of tasks, including pest management, nutrition, and harvesting. Regular monitoring and observation were also key components of this. Nutrition also rated highly, with nearly all respondents emphasising the importance of a balanced program that supports both soil and tree health. Most respondents achieve this through the application of mulch, compost, and both soil and foliar fertilisers. Another common thread in the survey was the use of consultants to inform pest management and nutrition programs. Other management practices believed to contribute to high productivity included canopy management, erosion control, effective spray coverage, and attending industry events to improve knowledge. The Macadamia Industry Strategic Investment Plan has set a target average of 5 tonnes of nut and shell per hectare by 2021. That's approximately double the current long-term benchmark average. However, as we've seen, there are farms within the benchmark sample that are already achieving close to this target. While every farm is unique, it's clear that the top performing farms all share common approaches. These include planning, monitoring, observation, and effective timing. This was perhaps best summarised by one grower who simply referred to it as boots in the paddock.